Quick! Get out! Get out of here!
All right, let's check the patch notes for The Sims 3. Kleptomaniac Sims can no longer steal subway stations from Watts. Sims can no longer woohoo in the elevator with a Sim who is on a different floor. The Grim Reaper will no longer be prevented from reaping souls due to band affiliation. Fixed a tuning issue so that Sims now vomit at acceptable levels. It is no longer possible to try for baby with become enemies with child wish no longer appears. Sims who are on fire will no longer be forced to attend graduation before they can put themselves out. Pregnant Sims can no longer brawl. Baby Sims will no longer become stuck on a Sim's hand while driving a car. Sims will no longer receive a wish to skinny dip with mummies. A meteor can hit a building, which case everyone will run out before the collision. Those who do not exit the building will die. Sims automatically leave if a meteor is approaching, unless it is a school in which children are not allowed to leave and always die.
Between murder and music.
Music performed by a rock group right here in the Bay Area.
Four members of a Midwestern family were murdered. The 16-year-old son is the prime suspect. Members of the experimental rock group Negative Land have been drawn into the case, and prosecutors won't even tell them for certain that their music, how their music might be involved. Hal Eisner has our report.
It was the kind of murder case that friends and neighbors said didn't make sense. They didn't understand how an A student from a good family could murder his brother, sister, and parents with an axe.
He was not a homicidal maniac. He did not show any signs of wanting to hurt anyone.
David Brom was accused in the multiple axe slayings, but now almost 3 months later, many are still wondering why. One explanation may involve a Bay Area music group called Negative Land. Negative Land's music is highly critical of the mass media, nuclear war, and handguns. The group thinks their music is humorous, but they don't find it a bit funny that one of their songs poking fun of religion may have sparked a dispute among the Brahms, triggering the murders. They say federal authorities asked them to cancel a long-planned 17-city tour and eliminate live performances until the conclusion of the investigation. The probe apparently involved their song, Christianity is Stupid.
It's hard to listen to the cut and not laugh. If you have any sense of humor at all or whatever, it's hard not to see the humor and that it would result in anything as serious as such. I think it's ridiculous.
This isn't the first time controversial music has been linked to tragedy. Charles Manson said his murder spree was influenced by the Beatles' Helter Skelter. It's believed Night Stalker suspect Richard Ramirez was influenced by AC/DC's Highway to Hell album. And Ozzy Osbourne's song Suicide Solution became the focal point of an actual suicide case involving a Southern California teenager.
What you can say is that music is a bystander involved to a certain degree, but most unlikely that it generated the mayhem. If it did, there'd be a lot more mayhem around.
Meanwhile, the members of Negative Land are hoping for a speedy conclusion to the Brom case in Minnesota and eventually a return to their live performances and a career that after 9 years had finally taken some positive turn. But a quick end to the bizarre murder case may be in doubt. A Minnesota judge has ruled that David Brom will face trial as a juvenile. The prosecutor wants Brom tried as an adult, and he's appealing. I'm Hal Eisner, Channel 5 Eyewitness News.
It'll be several months before the court decides whether to try David Brom as a juvenile or an adult. The date for his murder trial can't be set until that decision is made. That means it's also not clear how long the band will be restricted from performing.
Good evening. Today, our fellow citizens, our way of life, our very freedom came under attack in a series of deliberate and deadly terrorist acts. The victims were in airplanes or in their offices, secretaries, businessmen and women, military and federal workers, moms and dads, friends and neighbors. Thousands of lives were suddenly ended by evil, despicable acts of terror. The pictures of airplanes flying into buildings, fires burning, huge new structures collapsing, have filled us with disbelief, terrible sadness, and a quiet, unyielding anger. These acts of mass murder were intended to frighten our nation into chaos and retreat. But they have failed. Our country is strong. A great people has been moved to defend a great nation. Terrorist attacks can shake the foundations of our biggest buildings, but they cannot touch the foundation of America. These acts shatter steel, but they cannot dent the steel of American resolve. America was targeted for attack because we're the brightest beacon for freedom and opportunity in the world. And no one will keep that light from shining. Today, our nation saw evil, the very worst of human nature. And we responded with the best of America, with the daring of our rescue workers, with the caring for strangers and neighbors who came to give blood and help in any way they could. Immediately following the first attack, I implemented our government's emergency response plan. Our military is powerful and it's prepared. Our emergency teams are working in New York City and Washington, D.C. to help with local rescue efforts. Our first priority is to get help to those who have been injured and to take every precaution to protect our citizens at home and around the world from further attacks. The functions of our government continue without interruption. Federal agencies in Washington, which had to be evacuated today, are reopening for essential personnel tonight and will be open for business tomorrow. Our financial institutions remain strong, and the American economy will be open for business as well. The search is underway for those who are behind these evil acts. I've directed the full resources of our intelligence and law enforcement communities to find those responsible and to bring them to justice. We will make no distinction between the terrorists who committed these acts and those who harbored them. I appreciate so very much the members of Congress who have joined me in strongly condemning these attacks. And on behalf of the American people, I thank the many world leaders who have called to offer their condolences and assistance. America and our friends and allies join with all those who want peace and security in the world. And we stand together to win the war against terrorism. Tonight I ask for your prayers for all those who grieve, for the children whose worlds have been shattered, for all whose sense of safety and security has been threatened. And I pray they will be comforted by a power greater than any of us, spoken through the ages in Psalm 23. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me. This is a day when all Americans from every walk of life unite in our resolve for justice and peace. America has stood down any enemies before, and we will do so this time. None of us will ever forget this day. Yet we go forward to defend freedom and all that is good and just in our world. Thank you. Good night. And God bless America.
Get out!